Hold up, R. Kelly. I am not one of your groupies. I know you didn't even try to play me like
that. Wait a minute, Why are you going off? Just want to make you feel.
Standing here looking in the mirror, saying damn to myself, I should have known the day would come that she would plan
somebody's birthday.
I'm breaking off with a little previews of the remix. Now I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my next school. That's why I'm on.
What's poppin'? It's your boy Busy Gang Rob. Today we talking about R. Kelly again, man. It's part two to R. Kelly being found guilty and convicted of all charges of racketeering and all type of shit. They used R. Kelly as like the poster boy for don't fucking do this shit again. And it had to be a black artist, bro, because they tired of these artists, bro, doing this stupid ass shit they doing, right? But now check it out. R. Kelly, they used the RICO racketeering charge. Nigga, that's usually like set for mob bosses and shit. So they're basically trying to say that R. Kelly enclosed himself with his fame to make him like off the wire, like untouchable. You know what I mean? Certain, unreachable. You have to go through so many people to relay a message to get to him, so you can never stick anything to him. So he had himself so detached from the bullshit, but they were saying basically by these concerts, he was getting people flown out to these concerts across their state lines so he can actually have sex with these girls. You get what I'm saying? But so basically he was flying underage girls over here to have sex with him so they couldn't, because she's from California, it's against the law for him to have sex with her while she under 17 and a half, 18 years old here. So he would fly the girl to like somewhere like fucking Alabama where it's legal to do it or some shit. You know what I mean? Keep her there during the concert or wherever the fuck he was doing, you know what I mean? And allegedly, and then have sex with him and do what the fuck he was doing, shit on people's chests and all type of shit like that, bro. R. Kelly was doing some crazy ass shit. He was flying teenage boys out there and doing the same shit and actually filling their brain up with a lie of them being a millionaire, sold them a dream, smoke and mirrors, you know what I mean? Like sold them a fucking a facade, a great ass facade of them being the next him, or him putting their album out and them being the next Immature or next Aaliyah, the next whoever the fuck, you get what I'm saying? They wanted to be a star so bad, they was letting R. Kelly actually fucking suck and do everything else to them. Now, R. Kelly, bruh, he was taking advantage and using his stardom, you know what I mean, as a weapon. And that's what the government used it as. He was committing these acts with these kids, but was making himself untouchable. So they would have to go through like 3 or 4 levels, 5, 6 levels before they even get to R. Kelly. So R. Kelly would be like, I knew them kids was around. I don't know who the fuck they're talking about. They never met me. They might have heard somebody say that. Somebody might have sold them a lie and told them that R. Kelly, him, that R. Kelly told them to come get them. That's what R. Kelly was pushing off of and trying to discredit everybody. Now that shit didn't fly. The jury or the judge wasn't buying that shit. You get what I'm saying? R. Kelly broke down that interview. If you go watch part one, the video that just came out yesterday. That nigga knew it was over when that nigga started crying. Fight for my damn life! And shut your stupid ass up. Nigga, you ain't fighting for your life. You know what the fuck you was doing. R. Kelly, you could tell R. Kelly is a narcissist. You get what I'm saying? The pain that he went through, he's trying to inflict on other people. And he wanted to get caught. It seemed like R. Kelly, like, he wanted to get caught. I swear, something about that nigga, bruh. He wanted to get caught. It's like some people are on a self-sabotage mission. He was for surely on that self-sabotage mission in my eyes, bro. It was only so long before he knew he was going to get caught, bro. He knew he was going to get caught. And I think he's waiting to take people down. On that pedo island that everybody talk about, you from that island that Tyler Perry and Bernie Madoff and Sanders and all that shit and everybody else, the dude that just went down, the greatest director of all time went down and shit and he took hella people with him. They say they all go to that pedo island. I'm pretty sure y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about, you know. I'm pretty sure this is going to expose a lot of shit because this ain't the nigga to go down. R. Kelly ain't the nigga to go down and hold this water, bruh. They said he was singing like Nino Brown off motherfucking New Jack City when he went down. Cause it's way bigger than motherfucking R. Kelly when it comes to this shit. That's what R. Kelly's saying to you motherfuckers. So if any of y'all had anything to do with anything R. Kelly was doing, y'all might want to leave like Russell Simmons did and take your ass over to Cuba. Cause R. Kelly about to oust your stupid ass. And I'm gonna be sitting back waiting to hear this shit too. Cause I have some people in my motherfucking mindset and my brain that I think for sure is about to get ousted. That I know for a fact goes and do some foul ass shit. You know what I'm saying? Man, it's gonna be crazy, man. R. Kelly don't give a fuck. I bet if he don't get out in the next 3 to 4 years of this first motherfucking appeal, bruh, he outs the motherfuckers. I guarantee it. But it's your boy Busy Gang Rob, man. I had to touch on this subject today. I really wanted to get back on that shit. R. Kelly, they said he only facing between 10 and whatever decade, so 10 in life. 10 years to life, so it could be 10 to 25, 10 to 21. It depends on what they serve his life is in the, life in the state of New York, or wherever the fuck he got tried. I think he got tried in New York, right? So whatever they say is life in New York or Chicago, wherever he got tried at, that's what the fuck is life. Or Miami, or was he in California? If he's here in California, life is motherfucking No, he's in New York, bro. But life in California is tough for sure. 25 to life. He for sure be doing 25 in this motherfucker. Breast motherfuckers out here that did way less than R. Kelly, and that's serving way more time. You know what I'm saying? So you know money talks. Bullshit walks around this bitch. You know what I mean? R. Kelly hella dumb anyway. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm not turning myself in. He knew damn well he wasn't beating this shit. He probably, he might have thought, though, from the first time they let him pass, that he could do this shit. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what the fuck he was thinking. He should have pulled to Russell Simmons and took his ass on where the fuck he needed to go. You know, they said Russell Simmons did some shit. You see how everybody did Russell Simmons. Everybody abandoned ship on Russell Simmons, bro. They did him dirty. But hey, like, comment, subscribe, and share. Comment down below right now. Let me know how long you think R. Kelly's going to get. Do you actually think these charges that were brought upon R. Kelly are actually true? Or do you think they were actually staged as a big-ass plot to bring down and take down the king of R&B, which is R. Kelly, in his own words, and in many others' eyes, too? I'm not going to lie. R. Kelly got, like, the dopest catalog. You feel me? I ain't going to lie to you. And if you want to put it on a music standpoint, it's not too many people that you can even put up there with R. Kelly. I mean, and that's what made it so hard, I think, for people to convict him or to even believe that he was doing the shit he was doing. But for me, you know, me personally, I'm a realist. I'm a look at shit half full, not half empty, and be optimistic about it. But at the same time, the other half is still, you know what I mean, there. R. Kelly, you only see the celebrity side, the full side of the cup. You don't see the empty side of the cup. You don't see the life before. You don't see the life outside the lights. You don't see the life outside of his receptionist and publicist and his designers and all that motherfuckers that dress him and all that people, or his producers and shit. You don't see the life outside of that shit. We only see R. Kelly inside of that life making albums and shit. So I don't know, bro. You can't judge a book by its cover, and you can't assume. You know what I mean? Only God really know the truth, man. It's his story, their story, and the motherfucking truth, man. You know what I mean? It's your boy, Busy Gang Rob. Like, comment, subscribe, and share. Let me know exactly how you feel about the situation. What do you think is true? Did R. Kelly do this shit, or did he not do this shit? Because I'm not going to lie. You get conflicted with some of these stories, and you go watch some of these women on these testimonials, and it kind of make you, like, scratch your head on a lot of them. And then you go, you know, you got to just take a big, big, deep breath, and, you know, just, hey. Swallow your thoughts. It's your boy, Busy Gang Robin. Do this for the people. Y'all be safe.